Scoop-a-Scope is sponsored by
nonsense. Someone needs to tell Banyarwanda to leave R&B alone. I swear. Like, the, okay, R&B and rap, all Banyarwanda need to leave that alone. Anywho, woo, on this random Tuesday, my name is Tina Fierce One. Yes, this is Scoop on Scoop, the COVID edition, the lockdown edition, the 21 days edition, the quarantine edition, that we don't know how many days we are counting so far edition. Welcome to Scoop and Scoop, and it's of course proudly sponsored by none other than Coca-Cola. Let's get it. Sula! Okay. Like I said, I have decided to take this quarantine with a dose of sugar, spice, and everything nice. I will not let everything that's happening around the world get me down. As a person, I have decided to keep my happiness intact, right? So, I'm gonna look for things that are making me happy because I want you people to be happy too, and then we can smile as we, you know what I'm going with here. I'm entertaining you, but entertainment aside, my opinions is still valid. So, I got up, I think Katandi said the antelope circulating, that was yesterday. Okay, so I got up to a video clip doing the rounds on social media. Now in this video clip, my news is Nabagamba, TV and Aletari Aban TV Njita local television station. So, I got up on a certain local television station owned by a pastor at that. Yes, Pastor Sanyonga. They hosted Miss Uganda, our current reigning Miss Uganda. And, panel of almost how many girls? There were like three girls. And they're trying to make, they're asking her questions about Miss World. Did Miss World even happen? Didn't Corona just, yeah? How? Yeah? The other? Huh? You see, we don't keep up with our Miss Ugandas because most of the times, not to be. You know what? Watching the sugar coating, but the honest truth is, our Miss Ugandas have never really done anything for us. Not much. Actually, this one, I think I like this one because I saw photos of her down in Katanga. You know, Leia, I think she did something. All her Miss Ugandans have not really, they have not done much. Anywho, that is besides the point. The reason I'm having this conversation is that the entire social media scene is in uproar because of how these ladies handled that particular interview. Now, I watched the interview and I was like, I have so many opinions about it. And you know me, I'm not just going to go on the side of everybody who is like, oh my goodness, she's so unprofessional. First of all, that trick shouldn't even be on national television. No one should be able to hire her. I thought the last two times she was fired from different local television stations, my TV station, inclusive, yes, the only one. Because if you can open your mouth like that on national television without thinking about the consequences of what you're doing, then your stupidity is on a whole, it's on an all-time high. But anyway, my issue is Uganda has this thing where we have standards. What she did, totally wrong. What she did reminds me of the thing that they always say I keep doing, but I don't, because I give you advice at the end of the day. She, for me, when I watched the whole thing, this felt personal. Simanyo ba obabawe ya mukwanira ko mukazi. Simanyo ba bagabana yomu. I don't know, but for me, the whole attack felt a little bit personal because the clip starts from a cut, like kakat kayo wakaraba. They didn't give us the beginning of the clip. They gave us just the cut where the conversation is already heated up and Joani, nanyu ni chimwa, is throwing all this shade towards Miss Uganda. Now, of course, Miss Uganda, she handled herself. I don't know how else was she going to handle herself, though? Like, was she going to stand up and pull a Fabiola of like, I'm tired? Oh, Zari, what was she going to do? She just had to sit pretty and go through that. Now, moral standards of Ugandans and how we're so hypocritical. We have seen worse being done on regular TV and nobody stands up. But because you're all in quarantine and bored, you're like, we shall jump on everything and anything. This one, if you ask me, I am team jump on it. That heifer, those tricks, all of them should not even be associated with anything to go by the name journalism. They should not be in the same sentence. That is not journalism. That is what we call local talents. Yeah. Temuba Tugatako, we are not the same. In regards to what she did, yes, it was unprofessional. Now, can we move on? Can we? Like, it's that simple. Let's move on. Fire the trick. Chigwe. Mwine chacha mwagala. What more can Pastor Senyonga do? Nothing. Just fire her like that when Bukede fired her. They are not relevant to say they fired someone, and then what were they going to pay them with? 21.
Zake wa muzala. Chibu zate, by the way.
Because I'm trying to understand how social media is awash with different people, especially people that are significant apparently in society, saying free Zake.
I think people are using this whole free so and so thing very loosely. The last time I remember, the very first time I heard that word is when Nelson Mandela was still in jail, and it made sense. Free the man indeed. But Zake, Zake, yagabyo buunga bwameka, yagabyo nga kilo meka. Ngasatu.
And you see, here's the thing. Most people are going to be like, meka.
For how many people?
I mean, don't get me wrong. Abafunya, we are happy they did get. Now, the whole situation with him, Mwajite Gede. The president sat up on national television. He literally told all of us, because we had nothing else to do. We had to listen to him. He was on radio and on TV. And he said, abagalo kuyamba. Abagalo kuyamba. Wako vele simatide to us, we are receiving. If Lil Pazo went and he gave, and they read his name out, the president of this year nation, yasomieri nyari ya kanabe runabe, wanache chimu, teri nja ulu, wanaba naza. Anyway, so after the president came out and told this, and told all of us, if you have help, there are right channels to do it. Wike Yasoka Neitao Zake did not get the first memo. He came on national television again and he said it. Bana, abagalo gaba, mubirete wano. Zake, I don't know, mloza ina TV already, akayumba ke mga karabies. Chiwambo, ina, yeye nyumba iyo bapangisa. Bi mkwati yako watu vene wano. Anywho, tubati chari yao and Zake is arrested. Waba chari yao, they tell us to free Zake. To tell you, even Stella Nyanzi, who just came out of prison, was there. Freezer, Stella, how about? This is a random one. Stella, since you feel the injustice, it's too much. Tell them to freeze, okay? You go out and give Posho. Gano gabide chalochu. Tulaboma na otebaku zeyo. Like, I don't know, kanuka jogo. It's the honest truth. If the president has come out and said, bring the foodstuffs here or whatever it is that you want to donate to this place, you want to attend Senabagamba and Zake Yanta Mada Zake, akole ebintu ebitategereke, because Zake will run around Kampala, make his shoes dirty, show up at Bukede and tell us, you see, police has been chasing me. You look behind him, there is not a single siren, no police, no nothing. This guy is a clown. Let's face it, he's a clown. I don't know how much People Power is paying him to be their clown, but he is a clown. So why are we feeling sorry that he has been arrested for directly? This is not through other people. No, directly. He stood up, got the rice, and took it to his constituents. Under the guise that COVID-19 ready food. Tena tu kababe mbuagwe. Baja kusibebi sigadebi kwa tetele kere. I'm just saying. Mwena! Like, let me tell you why. I think people don't understand why the president actually said, if you have something, bring it to us. He's still trying to do what we are doing, social distancing. So, people here at Honorable Zake's place, there is kilo yomchet. Before you know it, if there is someone who is positive amongst those people, they are all going to get a bit of that. Because Ugandans, mutu manyi, we mugamba free. Blows, manyo, bulichimuchira, and they are all going to be like this. Ngamwena mufa. No, that is attempted murder. Didn't you say it is attempted murder when you... What are we even waiting for? Arraying this guy in front of my job, the magistrate, to anyone. Dangamne yesiru, wazata zake boboli mugezi. Boboli mugezi, do not allow to be anybody's pawn after this. Sit down with your political views, as you could see when you take your Facebook. But if I were you, I'm not allowed to be a pawn. Because You are so, so low below the chain. But yeah, like if it was the circle of life, this guy would be... He is definitely not the grass. What would he be? Like if it was the circle of life, because he's so insignificant. He would be something, I don't know what he would be. Would he be the... That helps the grass grow? That's you, Zake. That's you. If I were you, I would have my own independent thoughts moving forward. Vaku bantu ba people power, vaku NRM, vaku anything. Stand for your own political ideas, but here you are suffering for a color red. Bam CBA, that was the story. It's just because I don't have things to talk about. You know? It's tough times we're living in. Tough times. People are being stupid, but because they are in their houses, we can't tell. Especially my celebrities. But yeah, I saw Winnie Nwaji, Fefe Busi, Spice Diana, Chosen Blood, all in the same space. And I'm like, either these humans have been living together since this entire lockdown, or there's something off. Did they say social distancing? Bazunga bagenda. Like Fefe Busi, do you think you have a hit to write that is so pressing in this time that you can't stay home? Your Fefe Busi. Chosen Blood, we have been waiting. We are still waiting for another song. It can wait. We have waited enough. Winnie. It is Winnie. Do I need to say more? Anyway. Still talking about the things that are happening on social, because that's the only place things are happening. So I've been seeing Oyo Manerinya Baliogera Batia. I know her local botanical name, Nasenya. Is she Azad? How does she pronounce it? The Kenyan girl who did the Utowezana challenge. Now, I saw it on so many WhatsApp statuses for like a week, and I didn't know why it was such a big deal because I didn't want to download it. Then when I watched it, you have to be honest, she's catchy, you know? Flatter me, looking good, the lines that she chose for the song were just playful. But let's face it, this girl was selling us nothing but sex. And then after that, you women saw that you're objectified, lol. The only reason this girl was on every man's status is because they were thinking sex. Not, oh my goodness, she's such a darling. No. Why do you think after your got pissed off when they showed photos of her without makeup in and land the right lighting? Anyway, I'm glad that she's trending. It's hard to trend during these quarantine times, is it though? Everybody is on TikTok doing something, but it's kind of hard. It's kind of hard to trend. It's kind of hard. And, you know, she's a socialite. And my question is that, okay, so she did the challenge. People did the challenge. People did the challenge of the people doing the challenge. What else? Like, what else? I mean, I sound like I'm sour graping, but I think... This COVID situation has ruined me because I am honestly being very serious with the things I take serious. That's rare. That's a rare one for me. Anyway, she's a media sensation as of yesterday. And I haven't replaced her with someone. No one else? No! No, we have replaced her. We're doing the challenge with the clothes. All these people sitting at home doing some ish to keep them entertained. And then you go on Twitter, someone posted like, oh my goodness, her nudes have leaked. Then what? Seeing this girl naked is not different from seeing Cinderella, Sanyu, and what's her name? Judith Hard. Oh no. Judith Hard's situation in the southern parts is... That girl is special. You saw that? She, ooh. Hmm. Judith Hard, by the way, Judith Hard's genitalia, they should write like a book about how it gets like that. Either it's been you. Wait, what? I was talking about socialites. Yeah, what else? There's that Kanye West song I love, Can't Tell Me Nothing. Ooh, beautiful song. There's a part in that song where he says, don't open up your mouth to say something that you know you will end up apologizing for. Which, for me, it kind of like, it directly translates. Don't say something that you're going to end up apologizing for, which means don't say it at all if it's going to make you apologize. Now, Farida Nakaziwe took a moment. She was having an honest Ugandan moment and she wanted to check the people in power, the people who are responsible for so many things. And it so happens that on that fateful day, it was Right Honourable Speaker of Parliament. Now let's not forget, our Right Honourable Speaker of Parliament has done said some weird things. Isn't she the one who said there was a queue, and then she came back and told us no? Mampuri debubi, never dengamba. Take a queue, ringa, just to sanitize, and then we're like, what? Yes. Anyway, Farida Nakazimwe for once decided not to be the darling, the sweetheart of social media like she always is. I mean, Farida Nakazimwe is pretty much the only chick you cannot abuse in Uganda. I'm just asking. And better yet, I have another question. Before you couldn't fly into Uganda, the COVID is akusangire yaliwa West Africa. But before you got to West Africa, you had done like a miniature tour. Do you want to tell me you were not paid for that miniature tour? Or why is that the money you're telling them to send you? I'm confused, Kenzo. You're broke. I just saw Desire Luzinda and her daughter had a decent Q&A. And I, so you people are now finally ready to tell us all. Even Halimana Makula did a Q&A and she told us she doesn't like sleeping with young men. Lord. COVID times, quarantine diaries, I'm just saying. Anyhow, I had Samson Kasumba Bamusibi Dechu. Even during a pandemic, you still find ways to piss off the government. God damn. Lol. Haha. @TinaVS1 is my Twitter handle. And on Facebook, we are Scoop and Scoop and @TinaVS1. Not forgetting on Instagram, it's @TinaVS1 with an H. I'll catch you on the flip side. Wait, did I tell them my Snapchat? And on Snapchat, it's TinaVS1. Even on YouTube, wanna. I'm out. Peace.
Scoop is sponsored by